The word pyrometer is derived from the Greek word pyro, meaning fire, and meter, meaning to measure. Back in the day, the original pyrometers were non-contacting optical devices which intercepted and evaluated the visible radiation emitted by glowing objects. Since then, the term pyrometer has evolved to mean a non-contact device which measures thermal infrared radiation emitted from an object to determine surface temperature. Simply put, the best example of a pyrometer today would be an infrared thermometer. So what does infrared have to do with temperature? All objects having a higher temperature than absolute zero emit infrared radiation. The higher the surface temperature is, the higher the frequency of that radiation. Infrared thermometers detect the infrared radiation frequency and convert that into a temperature reading. How does an infrared thermometer work? In its most basic form, an infrared thermometer consists of an optical system and a detector. The optical system consists of a lens that focuses the energy emitted from the target object onto the detector, which is sensitive to that radiation. The detector takes that focused radiation from the optical system and converts it into a temperature reading. For example, most IR thermometers use something called a thermopile. A thermopile converts the focused incoming radiation into an electrical signal using a series of tiny thermocouples. The signal is measured and displayed on the screen in the form of a temperature reading. The big advantage to using an infrared thermometer is that you don't have to come in direct contact with the object whose surface temperature you are measuring. However, there are some issues to using an IR thermometer that should be considered, especially in industrial applications, like emissivity. Highly polished metals typically have very low emissivity ratings, since they tend to be very reflective of ambient infrared energy and less effective at emitting their own electromagnetic waves. If you point an infrared thermometer with fixed emissivity at a stainless steel pot filled with boiling water, you might get a reading closer to 100 degrees Fahrenheit than 212 degrees Fahrenheit. That's because shiny metal is better at reflecting the ambient radiation of the room than it is at emitting its own infrared radiation. Some industrial infrared thermometers come with adjustable emissivity settings, so you can more accurately compensate for the type of surface being measured. Also, direct line of sight is required. An infrared thermometer cannot measure accurately through transparent objects, such as clear plastic, clear liquids, and most types of glass. You can measure an accurate range of temperature through certain types of glass that fall within the wavelength spectral response range of the IR sensor. So if you aim at an object through a closed window, don't expect to get an accurate reading on that object. While IR thermometers offer a convenient way to measure an object's surface temperature, it is crucial to select the right type of device for your application to ensure accuracy in temperature readings. Still have questions? We have answers. Call or chat online with one of our engineering experts at omega.com.